MySpace you're at.
Hey, director, are we okay to go?
Is there an announcer for this thing?
Okay.
Makes you want her.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, so...
Could you guys play She's Mine?
All right, so welcome to Myspace. Hey, play this. Robert Weaver requests, could you guys play She Mine? Because it's my three-year anniversary today, and my wife wants to fuck it. Wants to fuck to it. My wife wants to fuck to it. Well, that's a great reason for us to play She Mine. I think it's got a good fuck beat. This is kind of cool, huh? Actually, we rehearse here a lot. We've rehearsed here pre-production for records, and we've rehearsed here pre-production for tours. So this really is a realistic and legitimate place for us to be doing this kind of thing. So. Sorry if it seems, you know, this the flow of this thing, it'll take us maybe a couple times to get the vibe of this thing down, but I'll try it out. Welcome, MySpacers. So, hey, play this. Bryn request, love the new album. Saw you play in Royal Oak in May, and looking forward to seeing you again at DTE in August. Please play She Builds Quick Machines and tell me about the video. Yeah, he's giving away free guitars today. And hats. Well, the video, we kind of threw around this idea right from the beginning about doing a spaghetti western, and then we were on tour in South America, and you know that idea sort of evolved into adding in these elements of South American freedom fighters. We talked to a lot of different directors and who we really respected, and we told them our concept and this treatment that we had developed, and we were pretty specific about it. And it wasn't until we finally spoke to Dean Carr that he sent us this treatment that really echoed the ideas that we had, and we met up with him, and it was really an amazing video to make. It was a lot of fun. And, as far as a very cinematic video, I think it's a pretty cool cinematic video. It was a lot of fun to make, basically. And I think it kind of echoes the vibe and the feel of the song. So here's the tune.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Let her roam. Eyes cold as the snow. She built a quick dream. Seems to keep her motor clean. Some of the visits at a wet machine. She's always quick to fight. We'll bring her through the night. I can feel it when the punch train down. I can feel it when the stool. Texas, old ex in Vegas, go back Texas. To burn through an inheritance, that's to cross America. At the all-night sex show, so far from home. I can feel it when the push train.
All right. So, all right. I'm Too Crazy for You, 15 says. Fall to Pieces is one of the best songs I've heard in my life. The music video made me tear up the first time I watched it. I just love the words. I suppose she wants to hear that song. So, I guess we can play that one, huh?
Sure. I think we know it. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Been gone. I've been alone here, I've grown old. I fall to pieces, I'm falling. I fell to pieces, and I'm still falling. Eternal memories. I feel lonely, I can't breathe. I fall to pieces, I'm falling. I fell to pieces, and I'm still.
All right. How's it sound so far? So this one is from Stephanie from Ohio. Thank God good rock is back. Slash, you've inspired my son. He is 15, diagnosed with ADD. The meds aren't worth a shit. The guitar is all the medication he needs. Be well, all, and never stop the music. Please play Sucker Train Blues.
Yeah, I will find you.
you know the rest. All right. Ruben says, the last fight relates to my life so much, and I think you should definitely play it. Thank you. It would make my night. How does the song relate to all of you guys? Well, I've talked about it a lot in interviews. I don't know any of you guys care to speak on that song.
You're doing good, Scott.
Come on, Dave.
Dave.
Dave. Dave.
You want to talk about recording your genius guitar parts? I'm sure it relates to you in some way.
No, thank you.
All right, so we're gonna play that song for you.
I think this song takes a really cool place in the story, the history of Velvet Revolver. It's the first song we've played together that kind of borrows from Rolling Stones and some really cool early influences that we all share. And I think we really kicked its ass on the record, and it's really great to play live. And we're going to make a video for it on Thursday.
Town feels like
moving right along. Phil from New York says, hey, play Get Out the Door because Matt's drum solos are fucking killer. And Dave's riffing is fucking amazing. How was that jamming in the studio?
That was fun. I dug it.
I think that's for, Matt and Dave, yeah.
We kind of set it up really different. We put the drums in your vocal booth. It got a really funky sound on them. And just really got the groove on that one, didn't we?
Yeah. Dave?
Felt the funk.
Dave.
How was that, Dave, jamming on that song in the studio?
That song was fun to jam on in the studio. Thank you very much.
Okay. This one's called Get Out the Door. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Bella from Tennessee. Please play Superhuman, because I want to feel as if Scott is singing directly to me. Scott, you fucking rock, and you're the sexiest man alive. Well,
It didn't really say that at the end.
Yeah, it didn't say that. I just made that up. Please sing it to me directly in the camera. Oh, man. You know what? Someone's fucking with me. I know that for certain.
I wanna be your Superman. I'm a Superman. I wanna be your Superman. Once again, the crash goes to be a man. But a man is a destination name unknown. Sometimes dressed up like a red hot lady in palms. Don't think you can get enough. Always feel like she's running on a hamster wheel. Getting high, crashing cars and making mistakes. Keeping her face packed with cocaine. Her face is numb, your face is
Yeah, you want to read one? You want to read one? All right, Draven X, 1976. When I hear Grave Dancer, it gives me chills. I picture my own grave and my wife dancing slowly on top of it. as if to be having one last dance with my soul. I'm sure that's not what the song is about, but that's just the vision I've gotten since I first heard it. Can you please play it for me? Certainly, that's actually a very poetic vision. And very beautiful one. That's a cool thing about music, man. It's a cool thing about you know, songs and being a fan of music. And, you know, I think that all of us are incredible fans of music, massive fans of music, massive fans of songs. And you know, that's the one bummer about when you do interviews and you have a journalist ask you what the lyrics are about, is I think it kind of blows it for the music fans in a sense, because I think the great thing is to be able to, just like right there, interpret the song for yourself. Sometimes you don't want the person who wrote the lyrics to sort of kind of ruin it for you, and well, basically, there it is for you right there. So yeah, we'll play it for you.
Pretty good.
Dave from Austria. Hey, Slash. That double neck guitar is fucking brilliant. Which of your guitars is your favorite one, and why? Just don't tell him it's that ugly red one that I don't like.
No, it's my favorite guitar is actually a Gibson copy, which I've had since 1987. I've used on every record, and it's the one guitar that sticks with me, so... There you go.
All right, so we're gonna.
Okay. Right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We're gonna surprise you with a new one, then I guess an old favorite.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Yeah, we forgot to work that one up for the tour. We gotta work that one up. All right.
Of you and I, this time you'll see. Oh, okay. Okay. See that. No, no, done.
Dug it. Thank you for coming. We're doing a big tour coming up, and we pretty much learned every song off the record and some cool covers, so it's going to be a big, long show, awesome show, and hope you come see us on the road.